It is Saturday, April 22nd, 2023. I'm out here in Chino, California for the annual Corn Feed Run, which is a show basically. They have cars parked along the side while there's cruising going on, which the cruising does start in a couple hours, so I'll be bringing you that as well. I do love these shows because there's a lot of variety of shots you can get, especially with the cars coming by. And obviously this show draws a lot of amazing cars. Just I don't know how many, probably thousands of cars at this show. So without further ado, I'm gonna go get started filming right now. All right, so I'm gonna start off down here at the south part of the show. I will say my Pacer is parked in the overflow car show lot, but somebody literally started blasting music next to me as soon as I parked, so I'll probably get it in the video at some point, maybe later when I get back to the car. This is a big show. I do have a lot of ground to cover, so we're gonna do this. There's another show like this in 2 weeks in Riverside, the Show and Go, which I'll be hitting that. I believe that's on May 6th. Next week, I'm off to Bakersfield for the National Street Rod Association show. So that's my next 2 weeks of shows going into May. So the cars are still rolling in here as well. Pomona swap meet in May, unfortunately. We have a Long Beach swap meet, though. I believe that one is on the 14th, if I'm not mistaken. So also, we got the Santa Maria Cruisin' Nationals coming up at the end of May. I might do the Culver City Car Show again. I'm not sure. I might have something like that. If I made you feel second best, girl, I would mind. Very nice 56 Nomad. Another 56 Nomad. Quite as good as I should have, as I'm good when I'm. Yeah. this 59 Edsel Ranger with a 6. This is Chuck Anderson's car. I used to be in the Edsel Club with him years ago. In fact, I had a couple of these two-door Rangers many, many years ago. Got a school bus with a tilt front end.
Cut back on the labor. I can come in and working a little bit.
So he's still working on inside there. Some of the vintage tractors and farm equipment they have out here. So just a reminder, I have a tentative list in my video descriptions now of events I'm planning on filming. Obviously life happens, sometimes there'll be stuff added where I'll hit something that isn't on the list, or maybe I'll miss something that was on the list. As the case last week, I did not go to Mopar Spring Fling. I had to do something with my daughter. More specifically, take her to Disneyland, because I promised her I would take her for Dapper Day. Very nice 1960 Pontiac. But for the most part, that's what I'm planning on hitting. Coming up June, I know we've got, well, May we still have Road Kings Burbank. I believe it's May. No, that's, sorry, that is June. I get this all mixed up. It's all in the calendar, just have a look at it. So I said we got Father's Day, LA Roadsters in June as well at Pomona. And then June 25th is the next Pomona swap meet, which is always a popular video on the channel. And if you missed it, I did film Pomona last Sunday, so that video is up on the channel. Then going into July, I'm still trying to work that one out. Maybe going out of state for an event, I will say that. It's not set in concrete yet. So actually it's the Good Guys Washington State. So I might be going up to Washington State to film Good Guys since there's not much in LA during July. So plenty of fun stuff coming up around the channel. Nice 58 sedan delivery. spare by that just rolled in. And they do actually have a big rig display. And we also have a lowrider 63 coming through. Big rigs. There's that truck show coming up at the Railway Museum. That's on May 6th, but it's the same day as Show and Go, so I'm planning on doing Show and Go that day because I did film that once. As you can imagine, you got to stand way back to film these monstrosities. That's beautiful vintage trucks here and also at that show. Got this classic GMC. Very nicely restored.
What about
nice stuff here.
Yeah, this old Kenworth. Actually, if I go over here, the lighting will be better on this side. Like I said, this is literally the kind of stuff you'll see out at the, I believe it's at the Orange Empire Railroad Museum. I know they changed their name a few years ago, but I'm sure you could find it. Someone's hauling hay. That's a phone for the kids too, because you also get the Railroad Museum thrown into the deal. I'll bring you the Chino Valley fire engine. I always make a joke of it, but I do like to film fire engines when they appear at shows. So it's of course a newer one. So I said Show and Go in 2 weeks. That one was actually originally couple viewers suggested I film that one last year, and it wound up being a very popular video and a fun one to shoot, I might add. Seem to do well with the viewer suggested videos. Very nice charger. This 57 Ford. Unfortunately, this show is very large, so it's hard to get details on all the cars. This 55 Plymouth.
They had a weird U joint though. They had a viscosity U joint. They would have half a U joint.
Oh.
Weird.
Yeah.
So it does have air, it's got the scoop there.
I took my pills.
It has 40 pickup.
Scream.
No. And a 67 GTO.
327 crank in it.
Uh-huh.
It's got 14.150. All rollers.
So 64 Pontiac Le Mans.
Oh my gosh.
Ooh.
Ready to go racing. Hey!
Hey, what you say? You get around.
You get around too. I just saw you a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, we got the Roadsters.
Yeah. Here, I'll show your car again.
Yeah, we were about 5 videos just from that the Ruckus show.
Yeah, yeah. Some with a little bit lower horsepower.
Take care, Mike.
All
right.
That was a nice patinaed Buick. That's a train, but not on the tracks that are right here. Or it could just be a train horn. And a couple nice GM convertibles, a 57 Chevrolet. We got a 56 Cadillac. White, which reminds me of my dad's Eldorado, which I still have. It's been in, I think, one video. That's a 56 Series 62. Of course, like I said, it's the one I have is an Eldorado. And it's stored at my buddy's in Palm Springs. So I did have it in the casual concourse video a couple of years ago. And once Coachella and Stagecoach is over, I need to go out there and fire it up and take it around Palm Springs again. I do not plan on going there when those events are going on. My 67 Impala. GTA Fairlane. It's not one you see a lot of. Oh, that's just a vehicle with a train horn on it. I believe the Cruisin will be starting in a few. It goes from 10 o'clock until 1 o'clock. Got some more GM convertibles, starting with this 1960 Impala. So I checked my watch, the Cruisin is set to start in like 15 minutes, so I'll be out on the main drag there. Look here. You don't see very often a 67 Pontiac Grand Prix convertible. I had the pleasure of driving one of these from Redmond, Oregon back to Los Angeles once that my father had purchased many years ago. His was white with white interior. Of course, this had the 8 lug wheels. Nice custom. And this 57 Thunderbird. 62 Chev.
Oh yeah, they're all green. Yeah. Okay.
When I say there's one at every car show, and there it is. There's the one at every car show. Your throwback to 90s car shows right there. That's when they were popular. Those were like all over car shows back in like the mid 90s.
Last time I 2 years, 3 years ago, my car started over.
The Datsun Chevy swapped Datsun with Lambo doors and 67 Corvette gills. '67 Chevelle. I believe the cruisers are actually starting to come out. About a Studebaker President. Torino 302 Parrard
71.
These are getting pretty rare.
Yeah, you can't find them anymore. Fleet line. Original F100 bump side. '59 Fairlane Tudor hardtop. This one's got a 302 swapped in. In fact, I need to go back out and see my buddy in Palm Springs who has the Galaxy I saved from getting crushed. And they just recorded it, so it's on the way to being restored. It's a 59 Galaxy Tudor hardtop factory six cylinder. '67 big block Corvette. This one's a 435 horse. Slammed and chopped Falcon Ranchero. It's got a Thunderbird interior in there too, dash and seats.
Top today, and then I was like,
are starting to come out for cruising. Cadillac convertible. Some military vehicles on display. blazer. Thank you.
And it was just
second gen Econo.
Classic Rewind, there's a new version of that song coming soon. Kevin Cronin is one of the guests on Dolly Parton's new album. She teamed up with so many musicians. The album's supposed to be out this fall. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
In the Pomona video, I had to go get the stepfather's 65 Beetle going, so I did the other day. Fortunately, he had a stroke, so he can't drive it. So I went over there, got it running. And he looks at me and says, "Let's go out." So I took him out in it and told me later on that day, he says, "That really made his day." He says, obviously, it made him very happy to go out in the Beetle. So that was kind of nice. Eventually, I do need to get the Beetle onto the channel. So that just goes to show you, old cars can make people very happy.
Packard.
your show. I watch it all the time.
Oh, thanks. Roadster.
The long thing kind of sticks out.
Okay. If the Chino police vehicle goes by, there's an Austin Healy going the other way, so you get two British Roadsters in one shot. '69 Chevy, and it's funny, as one popped up and picked apart a four-door Impala. So I measured the roof on my two-door because I still need a roof for it, and I did find out, in fact, the two-door roof and the four-door Impala roof are different lengths, so I wasn't able to get a roof for my car, unfortunately. If you're looking for 69 Impala stuff, there's one at Pick Apart in Monrovia right now anyway, with the roof, but it's a four-door hardtop. A 66 El Camino with a straight six. Have you ever seen one with a straight six ever? got a Chevelle four-door. You don't see the four-door very often in those. Zephyr. Here. Got a Model A and a Model T. Actually, there was a guy with a Model T this morning when I was getting Starbucks in Pasadena. Porsche 914. Yeah. Nice custom.
Oh, really?
Yeah, on the final. I forgot who's talking about. Giant radio flyer trailer with the handle. A Mercury Cyclone GT. It's one you don't see very often. I brought the Grey Poupon. That is Roadster of the 409. Get some of the cars over here. This is the overflow area. It's actually where I'm parked at, so I'm heading back to my car to get another bottle of water. And there's my Pacer. There's a video on the channel of the whole car and when I found it and all that good stuff and got it up and running. We look far back in.
I was driving, now the guy said he can't come.
Yeah. I'm in force with the memories of putting away shit.
Yeah. How you doing? Let me take gasser. The antique nationals are coming up at Irwindale as well. I believe I have that written down as something big a little hit. A couple 60s galaxies, a 66 and a 65. Finish up this lot and go back out and see if there's different cars cruising now. I was a little dehydrated. I sucked down two bottles of water very quickly, so definitely nice to take a little break. Actually, the Kiwanis Club puts this on. Selling hamburgers, so I have another hamburgers as well. All the proceeds from the show do go to charity. This MG had been different. About a 62 Impala parked at a EV spot. There you go. Closing out for me. There you go, parked at the EV spot. It's a car show, so you can get away with it. It's beautiful Hudson. It was at the Mopars and May show last year. Is coming up again, obviously. I forgot what weekend that is and what's going on. For the Australian viewers, Australian Falcon GT. The best camera. I got a pole here, so here we go.
Hey,
Nice beetle. Thanks to a 356 Porsche. Back to more cruising. Is the real Tiger King. Here, but something did. That's not good.
It's like the
that's going to wrap things up for Chino Corn Feed Run 2023. Next week, I am off to Bakersfield for the National Street Rod Association meet. So that one should be a lot of fun. And the week after that, I'm in Riverside for Show & Go, which is a very similar show to this one. Lots of other great events coming up. Be sure to check the list of tentative events in the video description. Be sure to like, subscribe, let me know what your favorite car was. And until next time, I'll be seeing you.